wasn't pretty. Larry the Axe Headache demolished the rookie in a mere 10 seconds. But the thrill of stepping into the ring with a legend and walking away with a whole $25 had Piper hooked. In the late 1970s, Piper made a name for himself in the NWA. Then upon entering the WWE in 1984, Hot Rod exploded onto the national scene.
I was Rowdy before Rowdy was cool.
Rowdy Roddy Piper was arguably the most obnoxious and the most irritating superstar in the history of the WWE. He was also one of the most entertaining.
We don't want to cause you guys any trouble because we know how intelligent you are.
In the 1980s, Piper's legendary battles with Hulk Hogan were unprecedented. The Rowdy one was the fuel that fired up Hogan's Hulkamaniacs. And it was Piper and Hogan who filled Madison Square Garden at the very first WrestleMania.
23,000 strong, not a one of them in their seats.
The Rowdy one operated only at full volume, especially in his revolutionary interview segment, the incomparable Piper's Pit.
Yo, Mr. Cameraman, come on over here.
You're a very ugly person.
I understand big body, little tiny weeny brain.
Everybody pays the Piper.
You know, you couldn't get a thing with a $100 bill on your forehead.
Just when they think they got the answers, I change the question.
He was one of the most hated superstars in WWE history, and he was one of the most beloved. Only a select few superstars could ever make that claim. Tonight, we are proud to welcome into the WWE Hall of Fame, the irrepressible Hot Rod, Rowdy Roddy Piper.